Hello, I'm EnterElysium and welcome back to From the Depths. This is our lovely fortress. We're still, of course, working on our attack blimp. We just don't have the oil. So today I think we're going to do maybe something over there. But for now, I would just like to mention that, bring the HUD back, we were having a problem with no fuel. For some reason, we had no fuel in this fortress and it was causing us some issues. I figured out what it was. It's because I had set it to not have any fuel on board because I was giving it all away. And that was a bad idea. Let's just lower the fortress, by the way. We're using a ridiculous amount of fuel of this height. Let's get us a bit more down. I was giving it away to all the blimps and so on. Which wasn't clever, because our new blimp, of course, takes a lot of oil and fuel and so on. It's a bit of a fuel guzzler. And that was not quite so good for us. Let's just get you down a bit more. And... boop. So, yeah. Now I've got it set to have a little bit of spare resources, ammo, fuel, energy, etc. So that should be able to be fine. But yeah, today I was planning on building a little thing over here. So we'll actually build like a little turrety type thing that sits on the top of there and can take enemies out. Because we have had problems with that mountain for ages. And normally I wouldn't bother. It's in fact not optimal because it's going to be stationary. And very soon we're going to surpass where we are right now and we're going to move forwards. However, I kind of feel that maybe it should be done. Because right now, we're kind of in a situation where it's becoming so frustrating, might as well. Now, before we do it, because we're hitting that thing so often, I want to actually reinforce our base. Because right now we've got, we've got a load of metal. And our base is mostly made of wood, to the point where it could be quite a powerful enough enemy torn in part without too much hassle, actually. So I would definitely like to reinforce this puppy. We have a lot of metal, so why not use it, really? It's my view. Got it, flaunt it. And I'm going to flaunt the crap out of all this metal I've got. And this side of the turret. Because at the beginning, we're kind of worried about it. But honestly, the new start gives you a lot of metal and natural to play with. So I'm just going to try and quickly do this. Boop. Boop, 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 boop. You know what? Why don't we armor the front of this, like, with a second layer? I'll make it pretty later. But for now, just chuck on a second layer there. And maybe something similar over here. I mean, it's got our engine in. And if we run out of engine power, then we're kind of screwed as a fortress. Because fortresses tend to fall out of the air. And by fall out of the air, they don't just go into the water. Wait. Okay, we've got enemies coming, so I don't think we will get time to build something over there. We're going to have to see what enemies they are. But just quickly add some armor on here. And yeah, we'll armor the front of this as well. This is a bridge. Like, I spend a lot of my time in here. And I don't want to be killed mid-fight. Because I'm also, like, one of the best repair things we have. Speaking of which, we should probably armor the resources a little bit better. Because, of course, we need them to repair. If we run out of resources, no repairs. So, plus, you know, very expensive to replace all of those resources. So, ideally, don't lose them. Boop, and my ammo is in here, isn't it? I remember putting my ammo in here somewhere. Oh yeah, it's over there, right, yeah. Let's just armor this a little. Right, who's coming for us? It is a barracuda and a ransack. Oh, well, this is not good. Okay, I'm going to start panic building, and I'm going to try and explain why I go on this. This is not good. For those of you who don't know, barracudas are basically flying air carriers. They have a lot of fighters, and we don't have any defense against these fighters, because these fighters will shoot missiles, and right now we have no defense against missiles. And we are rather squishy from the air, as you can see by the fact we've got a fairly open plan design on this fortress. I don't fancy fighting a barracuda. So I'm going to build an anti-missile system. So as you can see, that's a multi-purpose laser. attached to a coupler with loads of Q switches. That many Q switches means we shoot 8 times a second, which is great. And then we'll put loads of laser cavities. Now, laser cavities are basically the bread and butter of a laser system. As much as you use bread and butter to make a laser system, you attach laser pumps to these on all four sides, and these laser pumps absorb power and then discharge it when you fire the laser. I'm panic building. I know. I'm explaining this very, very quickly. Sorry if this is rather incomprehensible, but I'm worried as hell because this could actually end our campaign right now. So you want as many laser pumps as you can get for each cavity, because cavities do nothing by themselves, so they're just an attachment point. Then you attach frequency doublers, which increase the arm penetration of your laser. We need a few, not many, because missiles don't have much armor. They do have some. And then you can use frequency doublers, I believe they are. No, laser destabilizers, to increase damage even further. But it's a function based on how much damage the laser already does. It's something like you want a 3-to-1 ratio for these compared to the pumps. And I believe we have 800 damage AP7 at a 3000 range, which is great. And that'll take energy from the engine to power up in between each shot. And then we need to connect this to a laser defense beam. And that will shoot enemy missiles, but it needs to know what to shoot. So to tell it what to shoot, we have AI, mainframe, and then missile warner. And the missile warner basically has a hemisphere out the top of it, which detects any missiles, feeds it to the AI. It needs to be attached to an AI. This AI then can feed it to any weapon on the ship, including this, which isn't sort of a weapon because it doesn't need a weapon control block, but whatever. But anyway, that's to defend us against the missiles from enemy fighters. Now, to actually help us not get murderized so quickly and actually take the enemy fighters down, I'm going to build a anti-air missile launcher, which is going to be made of 'thumper missiles. So, new object, 2-axis turret. I want 2-axis turret because I want them to be able to point upwards, because we're going to be pointing this at the enemy. I will use a metal block, metal beam. And then we need a missile controller, 6-way. And I've got a mirror line down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And a laser emitter. Right, and launch pads. So the launch pads are facing the wrong way. The launch pads are going to be the seat of our missile. Then we put our missile block down. Do, 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 do. Panic building. Do, 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 do. And then these are going to trace the path of the laser. They're not going to use a normal function to hit their enemy. They are going to be beam riders, which is very rarely used because it kind of sucks. We need a variable thruster, which is important because we want to get as much thrust as possible because these rely on ridiculous amounts of thrust. I'm going to put a frag on just so when it hits a target, it can also do some area damage as well. So a 30 degree cone. It's going to be pretty wide because I want to do as much damage to the aircraft as possible. Aircraft are pretty squishy. Then we need a beam rider, which means it will follow the beam. It's the only thing that doesn't need to go on the front for targeting, except for a lure block. We're not using lure blocks as much as possible. And a thumper head. Thumper head basically converts kinetic energy of the missile into, damage. And ramp time, bring that down. I want it to be able to get to full speed fairly quick. Say 0.2. Arming delay. Let's get that to 0.2 as well. And I'm going to get not 1,000, 7,000. It's going to use a lot of fuel very, very quickly, but it should be fine. And I'm going to say assign to all the same length missiles. So this is a high speed, follows the laser and hits enemy aircraft and hopefully destroys them. Let's go back to the hull and we want to put down the targeting for this. So local weapon controller. I know I'm building very quickly. I apologize. I'm panic building. Mainframe. And then I'm just going to tell it to engage at a minimum range of about 670. Because it's not got a long range because it's going to burn through that fuel really quick. 7,000 thrust, and I don't think it's even a linear function of thrust on the variable thruster, I'm not sure, means it's going to drain fuel super fast. So we want to have a relatively short range. And in the meantime, I'm just going to keep adding more metal until we actually get into a fight. Because I am actually really worried about this. Ransacks are pretty tough, especially with the new cannon system. They're no pushover, put it that way. So I'm a little bit afraid. and they're there. Right, the anti-missile system should be working. The anti-air missile should be working. Okay, we're in battle. Right. I could bring in the somewhat in the middle of building blimp, but I don't think there's a point. It's still way off being finished. I don't think it'll be able to help. We're going to go for it. Now, because we have this annoying island here, I'm actually going to limit the size of the battle and only bring in one craft at a time. Now, the reason of that is, yes, it's me sort of cheating, being like, look, I'll fight you one after the other. But in my defense, the AI is incredibly stupid and can't do anything about this mountain. So I just want to make it a little bit more of a fair fight. So begin battle. You can tell I'm actually really scared of these guys. These could, like, quite easily end our battle. Right, I need to turn us. Okay, who are we fighting first? The Ransack. And the Ransack is getting shells on target because they're lobbing them over. And we're unable to. It looks like they might crash. We'll have to see how this goes. Okay, they are getting shells over. Our missile launcher seems to be murdering itself. Well, that was quick. Oh, we're shooting ourselves. Excellent. How about... Oh god, how about just stop? Alright, I know. Build. Right, if I put a AI left right card slot on, then a... Wait, no, I'm just be like... Wait, there we go. Only shoot above altitude 40. There we go. So it shouldn't shoot now. It should only shoot high up enemies. Right. Now this is where we're needed. Again. Our base is taking fire. There's only one way to save it. And that's us to go out manually. Because you can see right now we're still taking fire from their shells that can arc over. Now note, even if we had arcing shells, it might not be as good because... you know, width of a way, whereas they can just sit right behind them and arc shells over. So we need to get right in there. I need to take them down. Is that some of their shells coming over? Not just the red ones. This is bad. We gotta move. Yep, there we go. I can see green shells coming over. Oh, that's proper damage going in now. I'm worrying because this, like, could be the end of our fortress. It's the end of our fortress. It's the end of our game. As soon as we get that airship up and running, 100%, we're good. Because then we can take the fight to the enemy, we can move ourselves around, and also it's got a crap ton of firepower. But right now, we are vulnerable to a GG. So, move. Our first port of call, just in case it's got, you know, AI defenses. By that, I mean, like, other battle bots there, crew. I need to take out the weapons before doing anything else. At least that means it can't hurt us. Oh god. Oh my god, what? I'm landing on the Staten Fortress. Do some repairs while I'm here. I have landed inside the fortress. Inside. You know what? Screw you. I'm also going to shift us to the side. I really hate that drop pod. There we go, we're repairing. Right, moving us to the side means that they're only getting the red shells now. You know what? I'm gonna build something. see squirrel. Load. Can we build it quick? Can we build it really quick? Because this is something I built on stream that is a cheap boat designed for this exact reason. When we're being attacked, or if we need to just nip around, we can use it. Right. Go. It is a little bit prone to doing this, though. Come on. Right. I think we're going towards them. I'm not sure. Probably not, judging by the fact our gun's behind us. There we go. Just keep pointing this direction. Or not. You know, that's close enough. Thank you. I'm off. Bye. Yeah, we got basically nowhere. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Let's move. I'm hearing explosions. That's not good. Okay, to avoid getting shot at. Oh, we killed it! It's actually cut in half! Yes! Oh, what a win. I managed to capture the end, I think, but it got destroyed. Okay, this is a Barracuda. Its fighters are up. At least we're getting shots on it. Right, I'm teleporting back to the fortress because it will be needed. Oh god, darkness. Great. Okay, its fighters are up. Missing them with our Gatling cannon. Oh, close though. Close, come on. So close. Okay, we did manage to shoot a missile down, although another one impacted on top of our anti-missile system, which is, nah, it's not good. That's really bad for us. Okay, so our anti-missile system looks like it's out. We are hitting, yes, we got one of the fighters down, but there's so many of them. That could have been a missile, by the sound of it. They've got missiles coming in, they're all hits. They're aiming for our engine, by the look of it. Come on, build the anti-missile system. Build it, build it, build it. Yes, we've got an anti-missile system online. It's not particularly efficient. The engine isn't powering it enough quickly. Like, you can see that the engine's not getting enough power in. Oh my god, there goes all of that. That's the entire side of our engine compartment out. We're taking on the Barracuda of our main gun at least, and it is taking some proper hits. I think the Barracuda's losing that battle, but the fighters are my problem. Yeah, that's nice. We leveled up. Okay, we're just taking fire here. I'm not sure what we can do. We don't have any ammo. That's our issue. Right. Resources. Processed. Right, and since we just built a load of ammunition processors, let's also build a load of ammunition boxes, because why not? Okay, right. Building done. Still loads of fighters around. Okay, we are taking hits occasionally. pretty nasty hits. Enemy barracuda's down. It's just enemy fighters now. Not that that really helps. The enemy fighters are pretty nasty. That could be the missile system online. Why are you not firing? Why are you not firing? Five degree accuracy with far firing. Oh, we should have probably given you a fire delay. Why are you not firing? I need time to think about this. Not identify friend first. Staggered fire. 0.2 seconds. Minimum altitude to engage. Minimum range to engage. They're all on the minimum range. They're all on the minimum altitude. Why are you not targeting them? There'll be a really obvious reason. I'm just not getting it. What if I just release you from all your conditions? There we go. Something about minimum range, maybe. What, did you shoot yourself? I'm not even sure how you're doing that. I'll be completely honest. Warhead arming delay. 1 second. Come on. Please reload. Fine. Why are you just... I'm not sure why it's doing that. Right, let's just remove the fragmentation, because that might be the bit that's screwing up. Warhead arming delay. Oh, for God's sake, let me... Yes. Yes. Yes, these might work. I'm just trying to click this repeatedly. Right, there we go. Yes, we killed one! We killed them all! Yes! Ooh, for God's sake, that was a pain. Right, so 0.2 seconds is not enough. Okay, now we're just shooting ourselves. Can we stop that? That's bad. Bad Gatling cannon. Bad. Honestly, these fail-safes are a joke. Those fail-safes are an absolute joke in this game. I know they're meant to improve them recently in an update. I'll be honest, they are still an absolute laugh. They never work. But we survived. We survived. With 2,000 oil, so... We didn't make a lot. Please tell me you've got a lot of oil. 40,000. Hey, not bad. We might be able to finish the airship with this. Why don't we spawn you in? And resources. Here we go. One sexy looking beast. However, I've since made some small adjustments, so I'm going to tell you why that's not the starting fortress. There we go, attack blimp. Retrofit to attack blimp version 20, which is a minor cost increase in several areas. Noticeably, it's actually got a lot less oil. I'm not sure why that is, but I'm happy to go for it. Oh, and I forgot we're not attached to that anymore. Attack blimp. Come back. You're getting away that easily. Oh yeah. And because people demanded it, it now has eyes on the front. And no, we're not going to call it a narwhal, although, you know, narwhals swimming in the ocean, causing a commotion because they are so awesome. It's true. It would be amazing. But we're drawing from the Patreon list. So, you know, you can always consider them the narwhal class if you want. Although I believe the first one's actually going to be called Sky 99. So they are the Sky 99 class. Got a bit more ammo I chucked in the top there. It's a bit better balanced. We're still creating a lot of stuff. The turrets have been completely redone. And by completely redone, I redid the head of them because they were having issues locking onto targets. I think that having the actual barrel coming out directly away from the turret was causing them some confusion. How are we doing with the building? There we go, we're getting on with it. That's going to take a little while to get done, but I think we probably have the resources to do this. No, we don't. Where did all the oil go? Like, we had the oil. We had 40,000 oil. And I chose to retrofit this. Did it just, like, lose the stuff in the retrofit? I feel somewhat betrayed now. We are close to being done, but... maybe it was saying what the difference is. Although that doesn't make sense, because why would the difference be 120,000 metal? I didn't add that much metal to it. I have no idea. I feel like we've maybe lost resources to a bug, unless I'm not understanding things. But we're going to roll with it, which means that we've got a lot longer to spend here now, unfortunately. So, we'll be building something over there as some sort of defense. We'll build like a little castle on top. And we'll probably have to come back to you a little way down the road, because we have a lot more to build. Hey, at least we're getting closer. Could even be next episode, although don't get our hopes up, because my hopes have been dashed before. And I have no idea why we're completely rebuilding these guns. Maybe they just weren't completed before. It is more complete than it used to be. I guess that could be a thing. Oh well, and you see, by the way, I've put in some like partition walls in wood. Pretty nice, sexy. We've even got, you know, a balloon water start, so if, in case we end up on the water, we can be like, oh, pop the balloons, up we go. Now, it does also have anti-laser defense, anti-missile defenses with lasers in the front, the sides, and the rear. Although the rear one does not have a field of view above, so if we get shot at by a missile from up here, we're not going to be able to shoot down. And I was tempted to put something in, but honestly, I don't mind leaving a weakness in, just so it's got a weakness. Its weakness is getting shot from here. So, yeah, it's vulnerable to fighters, which makes sense considering the armor here is basically just wood. So I feel that's consistent with its design philosophy. But anyway, we're going to end the episode here. Quite a frantic episode, if you don't mind me saying. We did manage to defeat the enemy in the end, although it was one hell of a pain in the ass at some stages, but they went down, and we came close to losing there. We took a lot of damage. Oh, by the way, you can see why this patrol boat is named the Sea Squirrel. Imagine trying to shoot this thing with constantly changing direction. It never travels in a straight line, always travels in a curve. And then does that. Yeah. This thing is a pain to shoot at. It's also incredibly cheap. So I'll probably put a naval AR on this thing and just let it do its job. Although, do you even have a naval AR at the moment? No, you don't. It's not in there. Okay. I'll put naval AR on you and you can be in our fleet. Maybe we even take you out for a wander. Yeah, let's try and capture some resources with you. Why not? See what the enemy can do against you. Why not? Because I'll die. But anyway, I've been EnterElysium. If you enjoyed, please like, not subscribe, please consider subscribing. And until next time, when we actually go out for a wander, because why not? Stay shiny.